On the block. I love that song. I absolutely love that song. You guys, welcome back. Kevin, hi. Hi, everybody. Hope everybody had a wonderful holiday. Whatever you celebrate, I hope it was wonderful. It's been a nice, you know, few days off, a little break, and had such an amazing time with my family and a little break from everything. So it's been great, and I hope you guys all did the same. And I'm so happy that you guys came back. Crazy Chris is in the house. Thank you. And thank you guys for all the little gifts. I really, really, really appreciate that. And I've got a little bit of a cold, so bear with me. But it just comes with the season. So welcome back in. It's been just a really nice and peaceful, you know, couple of days, and spending time with family and friends, and it's been such a blessing. So, and I know there's probably some new people in here, so I'll just do a little recap of kind of where we're at. Thank you guys. And why I come on here. And so, you know, it all started with a breakup. It's what it was. And it was with somebody that's on this app. And it was made so public and so crazy for months and months and months. And you know, broke up in July, or I left in July, and I went and got restraining order, and so did other people. And then was quiet for 4 months, and a lot happened in that 4 months. And then decided to have a voice and to speak out. And to call out all the bullshit and say, no, actually, I have receipts and shared receipts of everything, and have trying to raise awareness about narcissistic behavior and the process of getting restraining orders and, you know, all of those things. And I think it's been helpful for me, and there's people that have reached out and said it's been helpful for them too. And so that's why I come on here, is to talk about all these things. Yes, and he blames me for everything. And by no means was I, you know, a perfect person. Nobody is. And I've made my fair share of mistakes. But you own them. And you take responsibility and accountability for the things that you do in your life. Every decision you make, you know, there's a consequence to that. And it could be good and it could be bad. So that's why I came on here. So it was in July that things just got crazy, and I got scared. And a lot of things led up to that, and I left, and I went straight to the police department, and then ended up about 2 weeks later getting a permanent protection order. And then there were violations to that protection order through contact. So there's 3 active warrants out for his arrest because of that. But those that have been watching for some time now, it is every single day, constant, constant, constant. You know, I've got work has a restraining order against him. My sister has a restraining order against him. And I've played the audio. I've showed examples. And so that's why I'm here. And so it was nice to take a little bit of a break and just kind of zone it all out. You know, because it was happening. It was happening Christmas Eve. It was happening. You know, it's just the constant, you can't stop talking about it. And so, but I'm going to continue raising awareness. I'm going to continue calling out the bullshit because it's just ridiculous. And there's things to identify in behavior like this that people should be aware of. And the other part of it too is that he will be on this app for hours and hours and hours, and monetize my name, the relationship, everything about it, and did from the day we met. No, he's not calling me, but he's still using this app to talk about me, my family, everybody. You know, was saying, oh, I never met his mods. It's because I have a job. I work. You know, if people came to town, sorry, but I've got a job to do. Most recently, now the big spin is that I use this app to go around the country having multiple affairs with other creators on this app. And I hate to break it to you, it was only him, just him. So no, I was not flying around the country having multiple affairs with multiple creators on this app. No, just Hockey Golf Dad. That was it. Yeah, Christmas Eve was bad. Yeah, with all that free time, I mean, shit, I couldn't even meet a moderator. And he never left the apartment or the house. So how? Yeah, I flewed to people. it's just insane. But it's part of some of the stuff that went on for such a long time. And, you know, when I went back right before Christmas and started kind of going through stuff, and I showed the last time that I went live, I showed or played audio from when he left me somewhere. And that was in January, and I had to walk home. And I was upset, super upset. And then, you know, played messages that he had sent. And this, you know, after January, it started to get really, really, really bad. And the obsession with the app and the obsession with people inside the app. And he would create these stories and fall into these conspiracy theories. And he had, you know, people would, they knew that he would fall for it. So they would kind of keep feeding him stuff, and then he and his mind would be convinced that things were real. And then it got scary, and you know, things going back on in Cottonwood County, it was terrifying what these people were, the information that they were giving him. And I said, if this is true, then why are you participating in this? Because it's terrifying. I mean, we're talking about real bad stuff. And why would you bring that into our lives? And why would you not protect your partner from this? Because you'll go live streaming and talk about it, but you don't understand the impact that could have if this stuff were true. If you got bought into this and you fed into this drama, and then people start noticing that it's you because you're public and you're on the screen all day long, and we're talking about murders and we're talking about all this stuff, why would you bring that to me? Why would you do that? And he would always show where we lived and our address and all that kind of stuff. And it was just insane. And so kind of looking at some stuff, and you know, and I continue to read and try and continue to understand these behaviors so that, number one, I have some sense of what the hell happened, but then also to educate myself and then share that information with you guys. I'm not a professional. I'm just trying to do my research so that I can understand why. I don't think I'll ever understand the why, but trying to understand the behaviors. And that, number one, I never get into this situation again because I've never experienced a person like this in my entire life. People call me naive, gullible, but yes, because I've never encountered this. I've never had to encounter this. And so trying to really understand and then share it with people, because people don't talk about this enough. They don't talk about when you're in the middle of it. You know, it's hard to talk about. I sat quiet for 4 months while this whole thing was going on and was scared and was a fraction of the person that I was. But eventually he loves the drama. Most narcissists do, because they like to be that center of attention. But the things that he has said on this public platform, and again, when I show receipts, I will show and play his own voice. And then I let you guys take that information and try and understand it. So it's his voice saying these things. It's his videos. It's his live streams that people catch, and this is him. This is him talking. And so I was trying to understand how, what kind of this narcissist denial is. And it's this really weird reality, almost its own realm that they live in. And why they do that. And they do it because they're trying to justify their behavior, because they actually do know what's right and what's wrong. I mean, he certainly does, and he would choose to make really odd choices. But they know what they're doing. It's a manipulation tactic, and it's a way to gaslight, and it's a way to pull people in. Again, they need that supply. They need that attention. So to do really weird things is a tool, a technique that they use to do this. And they'll try and justify all of their behavior. And they'll try and rationalize their behavior through their own justification. Another thing that they'll do is they will minimize anybody else's experience. And so you guys have seen this. At first, he denied that there was a protection order. He denied that there were warrants. He denied, you know, all of these things. He denied that it was domestic abuse or domestic violence. And I've shown the receipts. I've got them here. I've got my protection order right here of everything that was issued to the courts, and the judge's decision there, and the box is checked that it is domestic abuse and domestic violence. It doesn't have to be physical to be that. It could be a lot of different things, and it's here in the court documents: harass, stalk, intimidate, threaten, and the judge deemed that it was. So then he denied that there was warrants, and there were three issued because of violations to this protection order, which is permanent, which cannot be changed unless it's on my terms. And so I know that there's a lot of new people in here, so I want to make sure folks understand how serious this is. And when you do this and the courts deem you, once you get your first violation for a protection order, you know, it's a misdemeanor. The more that it occurs after the second one, right, then you become an extraordinary risk according to the courts. And it changes classifications. It gets a little more severe as a misdemeanor. Now, these warrants are out of Colorado, and he fled the state. He says that it's because my mom sent him a mean text message, but it was a text message not too many hours after my ex-husband was killed in a motorcycle accident, and she said, pretty much leave us alone. Leave. That Jen has suffered a loss, and you need to go on, move on. But then he continued to violate, and he continued to try and contact me, and he did it on the day of my ex-husband's funeral, right? You've heard him say, so now he admits it. So he admits it now. He made a video or was in a live stream or something, that was saying that, completely minimizing the actual warrants, and saying that he's not allowed in Colorado. Or how about he just drives here? That was almost kind of like a threat, but drives here and maybe not get pulled over. Well, here's the way that it works, and I have this from law enforcement, and they confirmed it, is if anybody catches wind that he is in this state, you call any jurisdiction and they'll pick him up. There's three active warrants. They want those cleaned up. They want those dealt with. So it's not that he's not allowed in Colorado. If he comes into the state, people will know and he'll go to jail and have to deal with these warrants. He claimed that he was going to fill out a form, and he also said that he was in conversations with the district attorney to get all this stuff dropped, because he said the cops thought that it was just silly, that it was ridiculous. Not true. So he had plenty of opportunities to contest the protection order, right? And then if he wanted to, number one, he never showed up for court. Not in each one of the three different protection orders against him, three different people, he didn't show up. And then if he were to have shown up, he would have 14 days to contest it. And he didn't show up, so we had 21 days, and we are long past that because that was August 1st is when he was served, and then court was like 10 days after that. So no, you can't just fill out a piece of paperwork or make a phone call to the DA and then they say, "Oh, that was ridiculous," and they drop it. That's a bunch of bullshit. It doesn't work that way. Yes, if he does get pulled over, the warrants will show up, and it's up to that agency to determine what to do. And because they're misdemeanors right now, they're not going to extradite at this point unless something else happens. Hello from Greece. Welcome in. Sounds like there's a group of us going to Greece in the summer of 2024. Woohoo! But that's just part of the minimizing. And so there's other people that he'll bring on the screen that say, "Oh, she didn't go to the hospital, nothing like that. It's not domestic violence. It wasn't physical." But domestic violence is defined in many, many, many different ways. And it's marked here by the judge. The judge seemed to think that it was. The other thing that is common with this behavior in narcissism is they'll negate everything. They'll deny, 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 but then claim to be a truth teller, right? And keep speaking the truth. And then they'll try and reverse things. They'll get hung up on something that is so irrelevant, but then continue. And that's what the projection that they use. What they're doing is they're taking their own insecurities and the things that they are ashamed of and trying to project that out and reverse it to make somebody else the bad person and for them to become the victim. And how that plays out on this app, I think it's important for people to note because it's happening publicly. And what's happening is that people are supporting. But what they're doing is they're sending money. They're sending money to watch this. So there's a couple of things here. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of this on this app. So what's happening is people are watching a train wreck, and they're not hearing the actual truth. Okay? And then they're supporting, but they're sending money. Not only are they sending money because they think that they're helping someone on here, they're not. They're sending money through an app that goes to China, and it's I don't understand it. I truly don't understand that. I don't understand paying to watch somebody do these things to somebody else on a public platform and then minimizing the whole thing, minimizing the entire thing. Help a charity, do something. You know, if you're gonna spend your money on this app, do your research before you send it to somebody. Before you send it to somebody that not only is behaving this way every single day, right? That's a felon that has permanent protection orders against him, that has active warrants for his arrest, that is unemployment, took unemployment, filed and took unemployment while he was in jail for buying that case of beer, right? May or may not have done his taxes and applied for Medicaid in July to get therapy. But made over $232,000 on this app last year. Those are facts. Oh yeah, and wrecked a boat. Wrecked a boat in Okoboji. Yeah, a year and a half ago. Okay, so when he starts making over $500 a day, and that's small now compared to what it was, but is the victim that has a lot of financial issues coming? Yeah, that's a problem. Unemployment while in jail is illegal. Medicaid fraud when you made $250,000 the year before, that's a problem. Not filing and paying into income taxes, that's a problem. So there's a lot of problems on here, and I've got a lot of problems with it, and I want to talk about it because it's people are supporting this, and it's wrong. And so, you know what, if a narcissist were to be, or if this person would be completely honest and actually own up and be the full truth teller that they say they are, they would say things like, the truth is whatever I want it to be in the moment, right? That's the reality. They think if it doesn't suit them, it's not the truth, okay? So they would say, the truth is what I think it is right now, right? The other thing that they would say is, I love taking credit, but I won't take responsibility. Now, how many times do we see this? I heard it earlier today where, I think I saw it somewhere, where it was like, I did a lot of great things and I donated a lot to charities, a lot of money to charities during the tournament battles a while ago. Take responsibility for your actions that you do every single day on here. The one-time donation to a charity does not make up for all the shit that you've done on this app, right? The other thing that if a narcissist was true to themselves that they would say out loud is that I am so unaware of how this impacts anybody else. Let's be honest. They would say, you know what? I honestly don't care because it's not about me. Yeah, it wasn't a charity. It was a clothing store. That's what they would say, right? And I think another thing that they would say is that I have a bottomless hunger for your attention. Those are facts. That's what a truth teller, that's a narcissist, would say. I think that they would also say that people are disposable, right? I think that they would say that. I think if he were honest and authentic, that he would say that people are disposable. If you're not gifting and you're not feeding into that narcissistic supply, you're disposable. It moves on. You know, and there's certainly a lot of people on this app that have become disposable, right? I think another thing that a narcissist would say is that, I want status, and status is important to me. And they'll do anything to get some type of status. And it could be being popular on an app that has completely changed over the past two and a half years and is catering to a different demographic. Right. And here's the thing, the app's not going to last forever. And it changes. It's changing and attracting a younger group. And he wants to be, and people like this, they want to seek that level of status for what they think is important. Right. Calling yourself a legend. They will also, or what they should say, again, is if they want to be honest and authentic and be a truth teller, is that they would say, I'm entitled to do whatever I want. Because they feel like they are. They feel like they are. How many times have you guys heard, you know, bitching about the app or, you know, like a First Amendment right? You guys, it's an app that's controlled by China that they can do whatever they want. Your rights aren't necessarily protected here, but they think that they could do and say whatever they want. And that if a narcissist were true to themselves, they would say that they are afraid of being humiliated and will do everything to try and make somebody else feel that way rather than themselves. So again, it's that projection that they, hold on, I gotta deny that, that they try and spew onto everybody else. Good night, Tina. So that's it. If somebody were true, those are the things that they would loudly say. And then maybe I would believe you a little bit, because at least you're being honest. Yes, here's to a good 2024. Well, it's, yeah, dancing in a store with people. I mean, that's just, yeah. But so throughout this whole process, again, still in the middle of it, and wanting to learn myself and take what I've learned and share it with other people, because I think it's important stuff. And I think it's important to talk about, but I really think that it's important to call out the BS that's on here and what people are supporting, and so that you really know who this person is. And there's so many others on here that are very similar, if not worse. and there are people that saw this for me a long time ago, almost right from the beginning. And I was naive and I was gullible and I had no clue. And if I would have been able to listen to somebody on here and actually absorb it and take it in, I probably would have done things very, very different. And so that's why I want to get on and have a voice and share this information. And again, shut down all this stupid stuff, in hopes that people don't fall into this trap. And there's a lot of money. There's a lot of money that's been taken. A lot of money. There's not a thing that he has done in the past 2 years that has been not paid for by people through this app, sending him money. You know, when he sends things to his kids, that's because of people on here. I don't know if Sky does, but I talk to Sky all the time. And we were messaging yesterday. I have incredible people, and there's a lot of really good, there's good people on here, and then there's some that I think you guys need to really do your research. Do your research before you send a penny. Just look into it and, but he couldn't be bothered to buy his kids. Well, okay, so this might be for another night, but I do have a message from one of them that was in March that's pretty telling. It was a message that was sent to me that had to go to him because he had that kid adult blocked, so it went to me. And it's pretty telling. It's a lot. So I might save that for another night, because that was, says a lot. It says quite a bit. But yeah, so I really appreciate you guys listening back, ready to keep rocking and rolling, keep ready to spread awareness, take my learnings, and share them with anybody that's willing to listen. And I appreciate all of you guys that have stuck around. Happy holidays, Johnny Hotcakes in the house. And I will make sure to get this video posted to the YouTube channel. So if you miss anything, if you click my little face there, there's a little button for the YouTube channel. And I post everything on there. All my receipts, everything, and it's there for you to watch if you are so inclined. And then also in my bio is my email address. If you want to reach out, please do. I just got a couple of messages that I saw that just came through that I'll check out. So thank you guys for sending those. And I really hope that you guys had wonderful holidays. I know it's Boxing Day in Canada, so we've got a lot of people in here from Canada. So I really hope you guys enjoy and have taken some time to be with your families and your friends and your loved ones. Take time for yourself. And I wish you guys all the best, and we will see you tomorrow night. So take care.